we are discussing important part in Indian freedom struggle, that is the SubhashChandra Bose. And his role in politics. First, we have to check out the ideology. Both Pandit Javaharlal Nehru and SubhashChandra Bose, both were impressed by socialism and interested to make India socialist. Particularly, as compared to Gandhiji, Subhashchandra Bose was considered as youth. Usually, age matters. You can check out, as we have discussed in decision making and problem solving lectures also, that thinking of person is depending upon age. It no doubt that we can check out, you have evidence. Just observe the playing style of Sachin Tendulkar when he was around 25 and he was around 35. You will get the change in attitude also, not only styles, but the attitude of play is also important. Myself, I can say that while I was driving vehicle when I was in range of 25 and I am in range of 35, different. Thinking capacities are developed. The way we are thinking, that is developed. Now, Subhashchandra Bose opposed Gandhiji in 1930, the Congress session held at Karachi, where they were showing black flags for Gandhiji in Congress only for not able to save, as Gandhiji was not able to save Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev. Certain things are completely engraved on mind, whether he is ordinary person or Mahatma. In 1939, Subhash Babu was president of Congress. Gandhiji was not there in Congress, but Subhashchandra Bose was there in Congress. He was having different ideology than Gandhiji and his followers. He put forward plan of industrialization of India. He put forward plan of, say, we have to achieve some success from the war. Now, the session was, he was become president in February 39, whereas World War II was there from 1st September 39. But still, it was very clear for many people in those days that World War is approaching from Hitler's move. And therefore, Congress was getting some radicalist support, particularly Subhashchandra Bose was there. Then again, elections were there for presidentship. And by this time, as Gandhiji was showing total opposite for Subhashchandra Bose policy, he announced another Pattabhi Sita Ramayya. Now, Gandhiji announced the name of Pattabhi Sita Ramayya. Gandhiji was not member of Congress by law. Whereas Subhash Babu and his policies were most popular in Congress, and then the election was fought, that was open election in Congress, and Subhash Babu was re-elected as president. Now this is called as Gandhian politics. He was very great in politics by showing that he is sent. And no doubt he was sent, but he carried out politics. And Subhash Babu was there in problem. In Congress committee only, he was opposed. Then the famous Pant resolution that was passed by 218 versus 133 votes in the subject committee and by an overwhelming majority in the open session. The resolution was indeed a vote of censure against President, which eventually ended in Subhashchandra Bose resignation as President. That's why in Hindi we are calling Majboori Ka Naam Gandhiji. I don't know why, but there was no necessary that Subhashchandra Bose should be opposed. But in politics, these things are going to happen. And ultimately, Subhashchandra Bose was expelled from Congress. But he formed the organization that is Forward Bloc under Congress. As we have discussed earlier, that Congress was having different organization, even Muslim League was part of Congress, or Barrister Jinnah was working with Congress as well as he was working with Muslim League. Later on, they bifurcated. Again, the reason was there of Mahatma Gandhi only. Particular, the Mahatma word made problem. Barrister Jinnah was not ready to recognize Gandhi as Mahatma. He used word as Mr. Gandhi instead of Mahatma, and he was simply opposed by many congressmen, and ultimately he left Congress. Now it was the turn of Subhashchandra Bose. Particularly, the high command of Congress was against Subhashchandra Bose, and then he was expelled from Congress for 3 years. Congress declared that there is no connection with Subhash Babu and Congress for 3 years. This is the politics carried out by particular high command of Congress. As such a personality like Subhashchandra Bose was removed from Congress for 3 years. That means, if you are, and what language was used by Subhash Babu? Whether he was saying that India should be partitioned off, Bengal should be kept separate from India, or anything that was not against going with Indian ideology. No, he was only encouraging, he was using or say synchronizing Indian freedom struggle with World War. But the thing is that this is game of revenge. Once Gandhi was shown by that black flags were shown to Gandhi, now it was turn of Gandhiji to take revenge. No doubt in non-violence technique this revenge is there. And Subhash Babu left Congress. That was not actually with willingly, but this was happened. This was the problem of Congress people, that they also carried out politics of revenge. Subhash Babu now set free. One British personality was famous in Bengal for his rudeness. His name is Halwell. And a statue of Halwell was planned to be erected in Calcutta, and obviously Subhash Babu opposed this, that the statue should not be there. in Bengal, particularly Calcutta, for the reason he was not good with Indians in those days. Then Subhash Babu planned another move, that we have to try for Hindu-Muslim unity. And for that purpose, he went to Barrister Jinnah, that can we do something, that now I am not there in Congress, so can we do something in order to solve the problem of Hindu and Muslims? Open-minded discussion should be there. Barrister Jinnah welcomed Subhash Babu, but asked question, are you coming here on behalf of Congress? Obviously. But Congress is not recognizing you as congressman. Then Subhash Babu said, I am coming out here to speak with you from forward block. All right. So forward block is party of Hindus. He said, no, I am not able to accept this thing. This is secular party. Then Subhash Babu replied, I am a Hindu and on behalf of that, I am here to discuss with you. Then Jinnah said, okay, I want discussion from Hindu people, not single. It is meaningless that one person can come and discuss with me. Instead of that, call Hindu leader to discuss with me. That was again freedom fighter Savarkar. He was president of Hindu Mahasabha. This is actually the intention of Barrister Jinnah was different, but he served nation in this way, that Subhash Babu was sent to Savarkar by Barrister Jinnah. In history, these miracles can happen. Savarkar was most wise man in those days in India. Subhash Babu came to Savarkar in the Savarkar Sadan. Sadan means house, which is in Dadar, Mumbai. Subhash Babu went there. Savarkar asked him in detail about his work, the reason why he came here. And then he replied, okay, forget of Jinnah and forget of Halwer also. You are one of the great personalities in India and in Congress. I hope something better than that from you. Right now, we should not discuss question of Hindu-Muslims. Right now, we should not carry out any movement against this statue of Halwer. Instead of that, you can escape to Germany from India. Already, our one of the great revolutionists is there with Japan. From 1915 onwards, Rasbihari Bose was there in Japan. He said that his letter was there with Savarkar. Rasbihari Bose was writing to Savarkar the way that most likely, Japan is entering in war in 1 year. Now, say this is the secret level letter. And international contacts to the extent required. Savarkar was having this all awareness of international contact. Rasbihari Bose was there in Japan. If question is asked, who is the most successful revolutionary in India, then obvious my answer is Rasbihari Bose. The reason, he engaged in different revolutionary activities, but escaped everywhere. And ultimately, he escaped from India and managed to immigrate to Japan. Other revolutionaries, say for example, Madanlal Dhingra, अनंत कान्हेरे, कर्वे, देशपांडे, भगतसिंग, राजगुरु, सुखदेव, खुदीराम बोस, प्रफुल्ल कुमार चाकी, टेक एन नंबर ऑफ नेम्स. दे वेर आयदर कमिटेड सुसाइड और एक्जीक्यूटेड बाय ब्रिटिशर्स इन डिफरेंट. बट रासबिहारी बोस मैनेज्ड even in those days secretly to Japan. Simple theory, enemy of enemy is our friend. And he was working in Japan. Whereas Subhash Babu was asked to visit Germany. That was days of World War. Hitler was entering in Russian territories, planning to enter in Russian territories, and at that time Savarkar asked Subhash Babu to visit Germany and take help from Germany. I don't know exact connections henceforth between Savarkar and Subhash Babu. Therefore, some assumptions are there because no clear-cut evidence, and obviously why they should keep clear-cut evidence. Only this visit is having clear-cut evidence. Subhash Babu returned to Bengal for thinking out this process. But he continued his fight with Halwell statue. And he was in prison. Then onwards, he accepted certain conditions from Britishers and managed to escape from jail. And then onwards, Subhash Babu's work was critical. He escaped from Bengal via Afghanistan, Russia. He managed to go to Germany. Now, our concept is that English is universal language and one can communicate with English, in English with anybody. But Hitler was fighting with Britishers. How he can communicate with Subhash Babu in English? Subhash Babu was brilliant, great personality in India. He learned German language. I am not saying that journey was easy. No doubt some planning and help was there from Savarkar. But still, individual intelligence and individual efforts are really important. The journey from Russia to Germany was not easy one in those days. But he managed that all. And Hitler also interested in meeting with Subhash Babu. Somewhere half hour meeting was there with Subhash Babu. In that, Hitler said that now I am there in Russia, but it will take too far for me to enter in India. So right now, we are not able to help you directly. But indirectly, we can help. Like our friend, that Japan is engaged in the freedom struggle. Particularly, Japan was interested in rescuing the Asia from these American and Anglo-Saxon hands. So you can go to Germany, you can go to Japan from Germany and manage work over there. Germany is with you. This way, Subhash Babu was helped by Hitler. Those people from India unnecessarily blaming out Hitler. In particular, this condition, they are saying, yes, Hitler is good. Yes, Hitler behaved very brutally with Jews. Fact. Hitler behaved very cruel manner with Slav people from Russia. Fact. But what about Britishers in India? Try to recollect how they crushed down revolt of 1857. How many Muslim villages were destroyed by Britishers in those days? How many Muslims were hanged in UP? Entire Muslim villages were hanged down by Britishers. This is also as cruelty as shown by Hitler. Many people, they are blaming out Hitler only. But Stalin was also as cruel as Hitler. Even we can check out that world's great personalities, they at some stage of their life showed tremendous cruelty, and several lakh people were killed intentionally or non-intentionally by ideology of this type of personalities, fanatic personality we can call. But here our concern is not to glorify Hitler, our concern is to get help from Hitler. And at that time Hitler was there in position to help by this way that he called Subhash Babu as president of independent India. Hitler was no doubt against Britishers, and Hitler was not willingly or say gladfully helping us. There was some politics. Suppose India was freed, then his enemy Britishers were becoming handicapped, and for that purpose he helped. That was not case that Subhash Babu or say Indians were Aryans. Many people are having this type of ideology, that they are saying Hitler was Aryan and Indians were also are also Aryans, and therefore he tried to help India. But this is not the case. He was interested that Japan should occupy eastern part of Asia. That's why French power, Dutch power will come to end, obviously English power also. The influence of Anglo-Saxon people from Southeast Asia should be removed, and for that purpose he helped. Anyway, he managed a submarine for Subhash Babu, and by considering all the dangers, Subhash Babu managed this journey. This journey is not easy in those days also. From Germany to Japan, say in First World War, Germany sent Amdel to India for rescuing Savarkar. In Second World War, they used submarine to send Subhash Babu from Germany to Japan. In Japan, Rasbihari Bose was there, was establishing Azad Hind, in English we are calling it this way, Indian National Army. Now there was war between Japan and England, America, as declared by Rasbihari Bose. This was the incident that happened. There was outbreak of war, and Japan tried to occupy different parts of Southeast Asia. China was occupied by Japan, and then ultimately Japanese army conquered Singapore. That means Japanese army entered in Indian Ocean somewhere 60,000 Indian soldiers were imprisoned by Japan, arrested by Japan, and then their leadership was given to Rasbihari Bose. The Indian National Army, Azad Hind Sena or Fauj, that was constructed with help of these British Army. Now here we have to be thankful again for Savarkar. Try to recollect when there was outbreak of war or chances of war were there. Britishers asked help from Indian leaders in war, whereas only Savarkar declared immediately that we can help. And he asked Indians, particularly Hindu people, to join army. He was no doubt having clear-cut idea that this army, whatever we are constructing, that is useful for free India, independent India, we can use that. And then this army, whatever used by Britishers, that was newly trained army, majority soldiers were, and obviously they fall in hands of Japanese well-trained army. Then this army was trained and considered as INA. What is most important thing, I'm not saying that Rasbihari Bose was not important or Subhash Babu was not important, but most important thing here, that Indian Army, or that is called as British Indian Army, was against British India. That means they asked to fight against Britishers and they accepted. Even Britishers were not expecting this. Earlier Britishers, particularly before 1857, they were saying that it is clear that once we are establishing our empire, that is going to destroy. But what is the reason behind that? We are not having any clear-cut idea. Most probably the powerful enemy like Russia will invade India. That is the probable chance. But here, more powerful, not enemy, Indians only tried to invade India from outside. You can have clear-cut connection here, not written, but you can observe that connection between Savarkar and Rasbihari Bose, connection between Savarkar and Subhash Chandra Bose, connection between Subhash Chandra Bose and Rasbihari Bose. All this indicates that some type of dialogue and plan must be there. Subhash Babu marched towards India. Now Subhash Babu was selected as general of this army, Azad Hind Sena, and they marched towards India. Myanmar was occupied, that is Bangladesh in old days. Now, okay, go back 1935 amendments or reforms. In that 1935 reforms, we discussed that India, Bangladesh, Burma or Myanmar was separated from India. That's why we are not calling this advance as advance against India. But this was there in the era of 1942, just 7 years later. And this Bangladesh was occupied by Japan. Then onwards, Subhash Babu marched forward and Japanese army on back. They conquested the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, named as Shahid and Swaraj. Again there is connection. Savarkar was there in jail of Andaman. That jail was conquered. Many political prisoners, revolutionists from Bengal were there on Andaman Island. they were freed from that. And then the famous battle on Indian battlefield was there, that is Battle of Imphal, Manipur, where Azad Hind Sena was defeated. Reason for this defeat we can see in different way. Say for example, by that time the war of Japan was shrinking down. America becoming more and more advanced, and Japan was problemed out by constant attack, and even accepting the kamikaze technique by Japanese people, the war turned towards European side and American side. Japan was no doubt interested but not able to help Azad Hind Sena further. The wartime experience was not there with Subhash Babu. He was a diplomatic leader, political leader, and ultimately he was defeated. Many officers were imprisoned. Subhash Babu managed to escape, but it is said that he was died in some accident, aeroplane crash, he was died, but people were not ready to believe this and are ready to believe this. But ultimately that ended the efforts carried out by Azad Hind Sena, or INA, the Indian National Army. So many reasons and achievements are there. First thing, Britishers realize that Indian Army is no more loyal with British Army or British Empire. Here INA proved that Indian Army with proper leadership can turn to Indian National Army. They are not recognizing British as their overlords. That was the greatest achievement of INA. Then charges were there on these officers. Out of that, we can say again the Hindu, Muslim and Sikh problem. So everywhere we are having this type of communal view. For example, P.K. Sehgal was Hindu, Shah Nawaz was Muslim, and Gurbakhsh Singh Dhillan was Sikh. These officers were tried by court, where Tej Bahadur Sapru, Bhulabhai Desai, and finally Nehru also appeared in the scene. They advocated these people, and obviously Barrister Jinnah also came. But Barrister Jinnah advocated only Muslim candidate, that was Shah Nawaz. But Shah Nawaz refused him as his advocate. He said that whatever the advocates of other two personality, that should be there with me. This was perfect nationalistic approach. And in month of December, these officers were declared guilty, punishment were given, and on 3rd January 1946, they set free from these all. That was because of people were with them. Subhash Babu was warning from radio again and again that I am coming from outside. You have to start struggle from inside. Then only we can achieve victory. And now we have to concentrate what we carried out from inside in next lecture.